Syrian rebels will have to get their medical equipment and generators from somewhere else, at least for the time being, now that both the U.S. and Britain have suspended, quote, non-lethal aid to the rebels. This after a group called Islamic Front seized a weapons depot from the Free Syrian Army in the northern part of the country. Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel, on a trip to Singapore, explained the U.S. move.
We are going to continue to help in the humanitarian area, which we have been doing consistently. But this is a problem. I mean, what has occurred here, big problem.
As far as lethal aid from the U.S., we'll go ahead and call that what it is, weapons from the CIA. It's not clear whether that will stop, too. This all comes about a month before the U.S. is scheduled to take part in the talks in the hopes of ending the ongoing war in Syria. I want to bring in our foreign affairs reporter, Elise Labott. Elise, specifically, what kind of non-lethal aid are we talking about? How will it impact the rebels?
Well, it's nothing, Jake, that's really going to turn this conflict around. It was non-lethal aid, food, medical supplies, communications equipment, trucks. But what this meant, the fact that the Islamics seized these warehouses that belong to the moderates, is really a wake-up call for the administration that their policy on Syria is really in shambles right now, because Islamists are really gaining a lot of influence in the country, not just battling Assad, but battling their own moderates. These are not guys in a cave in Afghanistan. These are al-Qaeda-linked rebels that are acting with impunity on the ground. Just in the last couple of days, the State Department is criticizing them for massacres on the ground, and there's a real concern right now that the country is going to be overrun by extremists.
So the policy in Syria has been criticized by foreign policy hands, including some who used to work for the administration, the Obama administration, as incoherent. Now it seems as though what's going on in Syria, even worse than whatever policy we have, just completely a mess. Is that what you're saying?
Well, I think the administration only has itself to blame, because one of the concerns and one of the arguments of President Obama early on for not arming the rebels, not providing more lethal support, was there's going to be more extremism in the country. We don't want the country to become a safe haven for al-Qaeda. Well, right now it's becoming a playground for al-Qaeda-linked groups that's rivaling Afghanistan, Yemen, and other countries. And this, as you said, is ahead of this peace conference in a month. These moderates on the ground are really weaker than ever. Now the administration has to regroup. My sources are telling me they're trying to discuss whether there are some Islamists that they can work with. There's a sliding scale of bad guys here. Some are linked with al-Qaeda, some just have more Islamic tendencies, and they're trying to see whether they can bring these guys into the fold so they can all have a common goal of trying to get Bashar al-Assad out. It doesn't look good right now for that conference at
this
point.
What a mess. Elise Labott, thank you so much. I appreciate it.